Welcome to Old Trafford, the place they call the Theatre of Dreams. And we're about to see what dreams are made of. All the goals from 1987-88, when United came oh so close to winning the First Division Championship. They've had that dream since 1967, when they last took the title. We'll also meet some of the personalities. Brian McClair, who scored 24 league goals. Brian Robson, captain of United in England. His England colleague, Viv Anderson. And on top of that, we have a word with Alex Ferguson, the United manager. So now, sit back and enjoy the goals of 87-88.
Thank you. down, sir. Why did you turn on that door?
Thank you.
1987-88 season saw Brian McClare scoring 31 goals in all competitions for United, and it must have been a memorable season for you, Brian.
It was a very good season for me, personally, to have scored 31 goals and laying to rest the ghost of the 20 league goal thing that nobody had scored since, or nobody had broken since 1967.
That was George Best's record. Now, the fact that it was George Best, did it weigh heavily on your shoulders?
No, I think if it had been anybody, it didn't matter. I mean, any player at United's obviously been a good player. I think that there have been plenty of other people that would have been more than delighted to have been given the opportunity to have a go. Just to play for United, and I might score 20 league goals for them.
Now, of course, looking back on that season, looking back on some of the goals that we've seen here on our video, we've one or two memories. Spectacular goal, I suppose. The most spectacular would be the one against Chelsea.
Yeah, I think so. I think that out of the goals I scored last season, I think that one would stick out in the minds of most of the supporters that were here on that particular day.
There was, of course, a hat-trick as well, and a hat-trick which made itself a little bit more memorable for you because it was scored against Peter Shilton against Derby County here at Old Trafford.
Well, I was delighted finally to have scored the hat-trick because I had threatened to score 3 goals in quite a few games earlier on in the season, but I hadn't managed it because maybe I'd squandered a few chances in the games. But I was more than delighted to have scored. And I suppose the icing on the cake really was the fact that Peter Shilton was in goals.
The goals which came last season mostly came from Brian McClare. We've seen all of those, or we are seeing all of those. I suppose really playing with a man like Brian McClare in the side, you always expect that that's where the goals are going to come from.
That's right. As you say, he had a phenomenal season last season. And he happens to be my roommate, so he talks me through all the goals every night before we go to sleep. So, he did very, very well last season. And some of the goals is phenomenal, really. The one I remember most out of all of them here is the one against Chelsea early on in the season, which was a great goal, really. But as you say, he scored lots of goals, and just hoping him and Mark Hughes will score a lot more next season as well.
Now, you're talking about Brian McClare, talking about his goals. What about you, Viv? Do you remember every goal that you scored vividly?
Every single one. I've got them taped in my mind. I don't score that many, so I know every single one. So, yes, I remember every goal I score, yeah, definitely.
Now, what about the difference between the clubs that you've been at? You're here at Old Trafford nowadays. You've been at Arsenal. You've been at Nottingham Forest. Not in that order, of course. Nottingham Forest, then Arsenal. Any big difference at all with the clubs?
Oh, phenomenal difference between Nottingham Forest and here. No disrespect to Nottingham Forest, but this is a phenomenal club. It's such a big size. Their training ground is bigger than Forest's ground, so that puts it in comparison, really. It's a fabulous setup, and it's a great honour to come and play for Manchester United at such a late stage in my career. So to compare them, you can't compare. Manchester United is the best for me.
And so to United skipper Brian Robson, then. I suppose, Brian, it was quite a season for you last season.
Well, I say that last season was a big improvement on the season before. We finished 10th in the league, I think it was, 10th or 11th, and we had a lot of work to do throughout that season, and we've come back with Alex Ferguson having his first full season, and I think the gaffer's done a great job. He's got us back up, and we finished runners-up. We finished with a lot of points, and we're a bit unfortunate, really, because if Liverpool hadn't have played as well as what they played in that season, which is a one-off season as far as I'm concerned, a team going through the first division only being beaten twice in the league, if they hadn't have had such an incredible season, the points that we accumulated could have easily won the league.
It was more or less an injury-free season for you, Brian, but there was one moment when you scared everybody. You fell awkwardly during the game against Norwich City. What actually happened then?
Yeah, that's right. I scored a diving header at the far post against Norwich there. If I can recall right, I think it was the winning goal, and it was just the way I landed. I must have jumped awkwardly because when I landed, my fist went in just underneath my ribs, so it just knocked the wind out of me. I think a lot of people were a bit frightened it was my shoulder and that, but since I've had the operation on that, I haven't had any problems.
And you ended on a good run with plenty of goals coming in the closing stages of the season.
Yeah, I think that was maybe it's because we got a settled back four. And it's amazing how well the team play if the back four players are very strong and they are playing well and they're giving nothing away, because it seems to give everybody confidence in expressing themselves as far as the forwards are concerned. And they go on and they do things that they probably normally wouldn't do if you were 1-0 down. And I think when Paul McGrath and Brucey got together and the way that them two were playing, it helped the confidence throughout the side, and I think that really showed towards the latter end of the season. And I'm just hoping now that the two of them can start off next season the same, and that'll give us a good platform to go on from there.
Well, for Alex Ferguson, the 1987-88 season was his first full season in charge at Old Trafford. I suppose, really, Alex, it was quite a memorable season for you.
Well, I think a lot happened, certainly. You know, I think that being at this club, that's certain to be anyway. It's a sort of a mixed feelings in a lot of ways. That I think, really, if you look at the season that's finishing second, with the number of points, was a fair number of points we got, but at the end of it, it didn't win us the league. And we've got to be judged on that, and quite rightly so, this club should not be accepting second best. And if it means that we have to be 9 points better next season to win the league, then so be it. That's the type of challenge and standard we should have anyway. But going out so well in the FA Cup and then going out disappointingly to Oxford, it left a bad taste in the mouth for quite a bit. But I've got to say, the players responded to that well. At the end of the season, what I take out of it, the players were just wishing the season was going on another 6 games because they were buzzing and they were playing well. And I made a note in one of my team reports, I think it was round about the Derby game at home, I think it was, or Derby or Sheffield Wednesday. I made the point, they're looking now that they can't be beaten.
So there we are, the goals of 87-88. 81 points collected by Manchester United and a promise from Alex Ferguson of greater things in 88-89.